produce some darker shadows within the kind of blocked in blue region of shadow that we've got so far. Now, I did let the painting dry completely since I last applied some paint. So that's why I'm kind of spraying the surface of the painting with water. So we'll continue the shadow area over to the where the rear leg is kind of curled up. So I've deliberately made this shadow a little more to the purple than the first shadow I had down, which, as I just mentioned, was kind of bluey. And then we can continue with this color onto this little lamb here as well. And I can use the same color on top of that ultramarine blue that I put down. And that's going to considerably darken those areas and bring them closer to a black. Even though I don't want a pure, pure black, you know, it's going to get them kind of right into that very dark shadow region. Now I need to do some little bit of cosmetic surgery on the head of this large animal here at some point, but you know, we'll get to that in due course, because I haven't quite got the shape right, I don't think. I think what happened is I don't think my drawing was too bad, but then I put a little bit of extra height into the top of the head without really meaning to. So we can perhaps kind of compensate for that by making the head just a little bit wider over here. I think that's going to help a bit. I'm just going to drag this dark shadow out that way a little more. And that's looking a little better proportioned now. Then we can move over to the little guy on the right here. Again, darken the region on the ear, put a little dark area in for approximately where the eye is, darken the nose, and then squinting at my reference, there's an area of dark shadow there and down here as well. And this is where the frayed nature of this little flat brush, I think, is really advantageous, because, you know, it's pretty difficult to put down a completely uniform brush stroke with this brush in its current state, which is a good thing, because, you know, the surface of a lamb or a sheep's fleece is obviously textured. So it's a nice way to create some texture automatically without having to labor over it too much. All right, well, now that I've done that, can we use the same shadow color anywhere else? So, you know, we can use that darkening of the shadow technique on some of these little stumps of grass in the field, because when I overlay the reddish shadow color onto the kind of green shadow color I've got, that's going to create a nice deep shadow. So it's all helping, I hope, to create the illusion that the light is coming from behind these animals. And then the shadows on the ground. With the animals kind of bedded down into the grass as well, they could be considerably darker too. Now everything's really quite dark and cold at the moment in terms of colour scheme, so let's grab some cadmium yellow deep and we'll take that and add a little bit of the alizarin crimson. And that might be a little too vibrant. We'll see how